So this way, Lord Chaitanya inundated all the people with ecstatic love. We hope today in the kirtan shall inundate everybody with ecstatic love. Also, this festival, of course, is part of the Panihati Shirdai Mahotsav, which Raghunath Das, he got the mercy. He got the mercy from Lord Nityananda. Raghunath Das, as a grihastha, he was very eager to join Lord Chaitanya. And he would go, run away and try to join Lord Chaitanya, but his father would always catch him and bring him back. One day he met Lord Chaitanya in Shantipur, and he requested the permission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to go and join him. But Lord Chaitanya said like this, Grihasthas shouldn't just leave their families, and it's better you serve in separation of Krishna. Do your, said like a woman who has a lover other than her husband, she does her duties very carefully not to be discovered. You do your material duties very carefully, but you keep your mind always on Krishna. Certainly such a woman who has a lover, she'll be thinking about her lover all the time. Like that, he gave the example. But the devotees, they keep their mind on Krishna all the time. So for 1 year, Raghunath Das, he did what Lord Chaitanya said, and over a year. But so many things happened. Like his uncle, Hiranya Mazumdar, he had negotiated with the government and taken the contract to collect all the taxes. So previously there was one Chaudhary who was a Mohammedan, and he had the service, so he just got cut out. And there were two, the deal of being a tax collector in those days, whatever taxes you collect, 25% you can keep. In America, the IRS is quite strong. But in many countries, the tax collectors have an opportunity to analyze and to give their opinion on how much tax someone should pay. So this gives an opportunity for the tax collector to underestimate a person's income, get some economical remuneration for this. The government gets shortchanged, but the taxpayer doesn't have to pay as much tax, and the tax collector becomes super rich. They have found tax collectors in India who are multimillionaires. They made a law that if anybody has an income, has property proportionate to their income, then it would be considered if they're in such a position that they've been cheating. But they had so many tricks, you know, all their nephews and their family, they just divided in so many ways. I mean, that's... Well, it so happened that the taxes that Hiranya Govardhan Mazumdar collected was 2 million gold coins. So they were allowed to keep 500,000 krugerrands. But in those days, I mean, gold coins, so that's a lot of money. I mean, that's millions and millions of dollars then, what to speak of, now. Then money had a real buying power. A few pennies you could live for the whole year. So they were fabulously rich. What they were doing, they were on top of that, they were cheating and only paying 1,200,000 gold coins to the emperor, and they were pocketing 300,000 extra. So when the Mohammedan Chaudhary figured that out, he thought, here's my chance to shaft the Mazumdars who took away my tax collection, and I was getting all the money myself. So then he thinked on them, and made a confidential report how they were cheating on the tax collection. and brought the minister in charge of the empire's finance there. And we're going to arrest Hiranya Mazumdar and go over them. And somehow they escaped. So all they could find was Raghunath Das. And so they arrested him. He had nothing to do with it. And they were threatening him, shouting at him, and they didn't beat him because they were afraid that maybe if we beat him, we're going to get in trouble later because there's so much local influence. So he was a kaista, a very powerful group of people in those days. But Raghunath Das, he had come up with an idea, and he told this Mohammedan Chaudhary who came to see him once, "You see, you and my uncle and father, you're all like brothers. And brothers are always fighting. I mean, sometimes they're fighting, sometimes they're friends. So I don't take this as a very serious thing. You know, now you're fighting, but later on you'll be friends again. And I don't understand why they're not giving you a share of what they collect." Oh, the words were nectar to his ears. "And you know, for me, you are just my uncle, and I'm just like your son, like your nephew or son." And then the Chaudhary, he started tears pouring down his long beard. So he said, "Actually, you are like a peer, like a Mohammedan guru. You know the Shastra backwards and forwards. You are such a living saint." And then he said, okay, "I think I accept you from today on as my son. I'll see you get freed." So he got him freed. And then he said, "You know, if you can just arrange a meeting with your uncle, and we can work something out. I mean, why should he pocket all the 300,000 extra? Give a little bit to me." So he arranged a meeting, and they somehow arranged everything so that the guy was happy, and the government was happy, and everybody was happy. Everybody but Raghunath Das is looking like they're cheating on their taxes and getting arrested. You know, "I have to bail them out. I want to go and be with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They heard Lord Chaitanya is coming back to Jagannath Puri from South India very soon. He was eager to go there. He tried running away. They kept catching him, bringing him back." This happened again so many times. And the mother told the father, "Look, why don't we just tie him up? You know, it's too much. He's, you know, running away." And the father said, "Well, look at him. He's got a wife who's like an angel from heaven. He's got money and a standard of material pleasure and comfort, which rivals Indra and the heavenly planets. There's nothing that he needs. There's nothing that he can't have. Still, he's not interested in any of this. If somebody is somehow touched by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and they become completely attached to Krishna consciousness and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what can you do? Even parents can adjust the prarabdha karma, this primordial karma that's there. So what's ropes going to do? It's not, you know, this is a special case." But then Raghunath Das, he got an idea, and he went to Panihati that day. Tomorrow. Of course, we're going to invoke the Sharda Sai and Gaudiya Thai to allow us to observe the Panihati festival today and tomorrow. Even though the Titi may be adjusted for the weekends, but it's a Smriti Utsav, it's a remembrance festival. So, when Raghunath Das got to Panihati, he saw Nityananda sitting under the banyan tree. And he just paid his prostrate obeisances from a distance, because he was sitting with so many Vaishnavas, so many saintly people, so effulgent, like millions of moons. surrounded by so many beautiful stars. He just paid his obeisance, somebody noticed, and look at Nityananda, there is Raghunath Das. And then Nityananda said, aha! Come here, come here! You are staying away like a thief! Chor, chor! Aso, aso! He just kept lying down. And probably somebody started shouting out, you thief, come over here, I'm going to punish you. You might hesitate to just run over there. He just stayed lying down, didn't know what to do. And he said, I'm going to punish you. You're like a thief, you stay away, hiding, trying to steal the goods. So I'm going to punish you now. They went over, and he's so jolly, Lord Nityananda, so humorous. He put his lotus foot on the head of Raghunath Das. Padibo! Padibo! So, he picked up Raghunath Das. He told him, I'm going to punish you. Your punishment is you have to feed me and my associates here a picnic of flat rice, chip rice and flat rice, same thing. Chura it's called in Bengali, I don't know what it's called. What do they call it in Gujarati?
Chavda.
Chavda. Chavda. Apawa? Poha. Poha. This was a favorite snack of the cowherd boys. You can just take this flattened rice, which is partially pre-toasted, pre-cooked, and you just soak in water, and it's ready to eat. And to give it some flavor, you add milk or you add yogurt and different kinds of fruits and things. So he told the Raghunath Das to arrange such an instant feast. You don't have to cook anything, there are no delays. You have to wash the chura, soak it for a few minutes. Actually, in India, you have to soak for like 15 minutes the chura, 15, 20, because it's very fresh. But here, because it comes by ship, by the time it gets here, it's months old. It's very dry, so when you soak it, it's like, it's instantly soaked. It's so dry. We have to be very careful that it doesn't break up into a mush. Yeah, that's our crew inside. We teach them how to do that. It's the science of mixing the chura and going to keep the rice grains whole in spite of mixing with all these ingredients. So we try as best as possible. So Raghunath Das, you see, he got this special mercy, and we'll discuss about the festival tomorrow. Whoever we're going to speak, they can read that section. But it's such a special mercy because Lord Chaitanya was brought there, Nityananda was brought there. Everybody who was there was accepted as cowherd boys, as associates of Lord Chaitanya. Tens of thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of people appeared there. And that festival is still going on today. So since Srila Prabhupada gave this community the name Nu Panihati, and Lord Chaitanya is eternally residing in Panihati Dham. So we're going to keep Lord Chaitanya here eternally resident. We need your help for observing this festival, also for chanting and dancing. You know, like Lord is present in his kirtan. Nityananda would have super kirtans. Also at Panihati.